Hey there. My video, The Coming Wave, How AI Will Change Everything, went viral slightly. 29,000 views. It's not incredible for massive YouTubers, but it is incredible for me. Over this past weekend, I've tried to engage with every single one of the commenters, and there was one particular question that somebody asked that I wanted to address personally and make a video about. The question was, you speak about the end of capitalism. Can you tell us a little bit more about that? And so that's exactly what I wanted to do in a short video this morning. I know that it sounds absolutely bonkers and incredible to contemplate that something like capitalism, which is basically one of the pillars of modern civilization, one of the pillars of modern society, an economic structure that each and everyone alive today has known and lived through, except if you're in North Korea, perhaps, but even in China, capitalism influences daily life. It's incredible to believe that something like that could end. However, if we look at what's going on in the world today, and you take it in and you think about it rationally, it really becomes a lot easier to contemplate this idea. First of all, we need to accept the premise that nothing lasts forever, right? Nothing lasts forever. Even the sun, even the earth will disappear one day, right? They've not always been here. They will not always be here. And certainly the same goes for any kind of human created mechanism, right? Any kind of human created structure or idea will inevitably disappear at some point. Now, some things last longer than others, but we have to realize that humanity has been around for 200,000 years, and it's been less than 10,000 years that we even had anything akin to a bartering system where people exchange things like that, right? I guess that 200,000 years ago, when we first started to roam the plains of Africa as hunter-gatherers and in Europe, of course, we would have exchanged things as well. Okay, I have some berries, you have a piece of meat, of course. But around 10,000 years ago, as the agrarian revolution took shape, it's probably the first time when we started to go about that in more organized manners. And then about maybe 6,000 years ago, as far as I know, we saw the rise of the first kind of monetary systems in the first city-states and the first civilizations that arose. And ultimately, we saw the first kind of banking systems arrive. And then later on, that turned into we starting to look for new ways of exchanging value. And we started using, for example, seashells or shells is what's being used, for example, in the Pacific by the indigenous tribes there. And all over the world, there are different ways of exchanging value. And ultimately, that led to money today. That led to capitalism. But the idea that this is something that will last forever is simply ridiculous. It won't, right? So if we know that, we accept that capitalism will have to end one day, then ask yourself, why is it so incredibly crazy to think that it might end within our lifetime, right? It's not impossible. Cool. So now we've accepted that. We accept that it can end. We accept that it will not last forever. We accepted that it might even end in our lifetime, even if at this point we still believe that is a fairly low statistic possibility. But now look at the world today, right? It is 100% certain that our economies are spinning out of control. We've already had an economic meltdown at the end of the 2010s. The whole world suffered. Banks were collapsing and they had to be bailed out. We barely made it through on the skin of our teeth. Yes? In the world today, and I'm not an economist, but I can tell you, and you can go and look this up for yourself, there are plenty of signs that we are again heading for an economic meltdown. And many of these signs are exactly the same as they were at the end of the 2010s. But even if we ignore that, then we still have to face up to the fact that the idea of infinite growth, endless growth, is also unsustainable, right? It's impossible to maintain infinite economic growth, because infinite economic growth means that we need to infinitely be increasing the amount of resources that we use. And although we might at some point become multiplanetary, and if even we might someday leave the solar system, the physical limitations in crossing the universe to other planets, or crossing the cosmos to other planets and ultimately other solar systems and galaxies, are incomprehensibly bigger than anything that we could achieve here on Earth first. It will, even if AI accelerates us exponentially forward in terms of technological development, it will still probably be centuries before we can leave the solar system. And it will be at least a century before we start to truly harness the resources that our own solar system has to offer, even if we might start harvesting comets or asteroids over the next few decades due to SpaceX. That means that if we want to keep progressing as human beings, that we need to find different ways of growing that do not require endless economic growth in the current sense, right? We need to come to grips to a kind of system that allows us to grow technologically and that allows us to grow our consciousness and our civilization, but that does not require economic growth in the sense that we need to keep using resources that our planet cannot offer us. So now if we accept all of these variables and we look at the world today, we see that wealth disparity is growing at an exponential rate again, right? It stopped in the last century after the Second World War because a massive amount of wealth in the world was destroyed, and therefore that disparity slowed down to a trickle, and then it reversed, and then all up to the 90s, basically the whole world was growing in wealth. But since the 90s, disparity has been growing again. That means that the richer are getting richer, and the poorer are getting poorer, and more of us are getting poor every day again. Right? This is true. And although Ray Kurzweil, for example, denies this in The Singularity is Nearer, and he comes with all these kind of cherry-picked statistics to show that everything's only getting better, he was right about that for most of the last century, but that's not true anymore today. So we have growing wealth disparity, which can be clearly seen already. We know that it cannot last forever. We know that we cannot keep using up the resources of our planet in an endless kind of sick growth, because it's basically an economic cancer. And that is what capitalism is, and neoliberalism. So if we accept all of these things, and we then realize that we are now entering an age where AI and robotics will completely act as the most deflationary technological force in human history, that will make any human labor redundant, right? That means that every single person listening to this video today can be 100% assured that within the next two decades, they will no longer be required to perform any labor, be that intellectual or physical. But if humans do not provide labor, for which they are then rewarded monetarily, then they do not have any money to buy any products. Therefore, we cannot sustain a consumer economy. Therefore, capitalism cannot function. Therefore, it is inevitable that capitalism will collapse in on itself, and governments will be forced to come up first with a temporary stopgap solution, which will probably be universal basic income. And then, in order to move the world forward, together with central banks and corporations, they will have to look for a new kind of economic model. And if we are going down the right path, that means that in Western democracy, our populations, our demographics, will be involved in the decision-making and in the formation and structuring of a new kind of economic model for our nations and our world to go forth. And this will not include any money. However, going from where we are today to where I think we should be going in the future, or where we will be going, is of course not something that will just easily happen, just like that. It will involve a period of struggle and strife and challenge, and some of us will suffer more than others to get to the utopia that may lie ahead of us. But one thing is for sure, as far as I can see it, the world as we know today will come to an end in the next 20 to 30 years. There's just no doubt about that in my mind. I hope this was useful to you. If you found value in today's content, please make sure to like and subscribe. Leave a comment for the algorithm to help other people find this video as well. That's it for now. Aragorn, aka Mr. Metaverse, signing off. Thank you so much, and see you in the next one.